त्वमेव बन्धो च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविडं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव
श्री गणेशाय नमः ॐ भद्रं कर्णेभिः शृणुयाम देवाः भद्रं पश्यमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवांसस्तनूभिः व्यशेम देवहितं यदायुः ॐ स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः
राखिए, देवा जो भक्ति तेरा जिए, उसे अमृत का है मोह क्या, हंस के विष का वो प्याला पिए, तेरी महिमा की छाया तले, काल के रथ का पहिया चले, एक चिंगारी प्रतिशोध से खड़ी रावण की लंका जले, शत्रुओं की कतारे
absolute pleasure to welcome you to this evening, a curtain raiser that supports World Culture Festival to be held in New Delhi, India from March 13th.
So before we start, I'm going to talk about oneness and I'm going to talk about culture. And just let's take 30 seconds, okay, to turn to the person on the left and say, introduce yourself to the person on your left. My name is Kevin. I grew up on a planet where lots of strawberry ice cream and mango ice cream. I'm kidding. Some of you might just have a problem identifying something. So what I'd like you to do is just turn to the person on the left, introduce yourself and say, my name is so-and-so, I come from this particular place, and what a pleasure to meet you. Try that. I think there are some folks sitting next to their spouses and found it kind of awkward, but I'm glad that you got to reintroduce yourself to your spouses and, you know, kind of get to know more about them. So that's wonderful. So culture is a total way of life that people in society are blessed with. You know, culture is characteristic of particular groups of people, defined by everything from language, religion, cuisine, social habits, music, art. And through culture, we are governed by norms and customs, which are the pillars of any society. And if these pillars are not properly followed in our society, our culture will resemble a perfume. It sort of resembles a perfume, except it has no smell. And you know, it's a gradual existence of presenting those norms and customs to people who surround us through religion, music, dances, arts, crafts, food, dressing, style, languages, just to mention a few. Now, human empowerment and understanding, respecting through collaboration of diverse culture, could make your soul feel like you've traveled many, many parts of the whole wide world. It makes you feel like you've connected with several cities, deeply embodied by people from all walks of life. Now, this particular event, being one of its kind, is a celebration of the Art of Living's 35 years of service, humanity, spirituality, and human values. The Art of Living Foundation is an international non-profit educational humanitarian organization, and the festival will celebrate the diversity in cultures from across the world while simultaneously highlighting our unity as a human family. Now, this is where we emphasize the power of oneness, bringing together people of all diversity, making us feel as one. And to celebrate Art of Living's 35 years service, it's a singular honor, and indeed for me and indeed for many people out here, a singular honor to mention the founder of Art of Living, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, a figure of peace playing a crucial role in conflict resolution. And he spreads his vision of non-violence at public forums and gatherings worldwide. Now regarded as a neutral figure with a sole agenda of peace, he represents hope to people in regions of conflict, in a world that's overshadowed and governed by hate, anger, dispute, lack of respect and understanding. Now, I felt it right to emphasize Sri Sri Ravi Shankar as an ambassador of peace. Well-rounded and embodied in the spirit of love and oneness, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar is a humanitarian leader, spiritual teacher, and his vision for a stress-free, violence-free society has united millions of people all over the world through service, projects, through courses of Art of Living. Now, the world is plagued by war, violence. Yet we all know the power of love in total oneness can eradicate the current problems we face. Hence, your presence tonight is a direct support for our cause and our vision for world peace. So you lovely people being part of this particular event here could contribute to arguably one of the largest peace events, and this is going to prove to be very historical. So without further delay, I want to introduce you to Chandini Dhivori, Art of Living teacher for the last 14 years. And Chandini has taken the time to get together many events for this particular function so that we're going to be entertained. And I do have a request. This is a very important organization, an important evening. So if you could, you know, be attentive, listen, you know, watch the events that are being planned out to you. Try and stay off Facebook if that helps. You know, social media is fantastic, but you know, cut off today. Just enjoy the event, and you know, if you have the opportunity, stay off your phones. That'll be fantastic. Before I hand you over to Chandini, a little bit of myself. How do I summarize myself? I am still insanely and utterly in love with my parents and my family and my friends. So that's how I describe myself. And welcome to our festival. I hand you over to Chandini.
Thank you, Kevin. Thank you all for coming tonight. Let's start our program with Ganesh Kavudhu by Rithyanda Subramaniam. It is performed by Rithyanda. Mahalakshmi Vardhan is the choreographer for this. It is from Nupura Dance Academy. And as you all know, Ganesha is the energy which brings the group together. So let's put hands together. Let's enjoy the show. And also we have Shalini Parekh is going to be one of our presenters for tonight. Shalini. Ooh. keda aruli ganna patti jaya jaya hari tir margani vena vinayaga pinai keda aruli ganna patti jaya jaya hari tir margani vena vinayaga pinai keda aruli ganna patti jaya
Good evening, everybody. My name is Mahalakshmi Varadhan, director of Bhubura Dance Academy. The first dance which you saw is a Ganapati Kautubha. It's a dance on Lord Ganesha. The second dance is Nataraj Anjali. We're devoting this dance to Lord Shiva. The third dance, one more is coming up. It's going to be again on Lord Ganesha. And then the final one is a Thilana. It's the longest piece in one of the Bharatanatyam. It's called Thilana. It's very intricate steps and very complicated adavus. And Bharatanatyam is originally from India, from the state Tamil Nadu. And hope you enjoy the program. Thank you.
Thank you. Takata jadu din, 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 takata jadu din Cultural festival in the form of these dances here depicting Ganesha and Shiva, the very essence of creation. Ganesha with his large ears, embody intellect, beauty and knowledge, and Shiva with his transcendental dancing representing the oneness, the innocence and the beauty in the creation and indeed in all of us. So Kevin, I'm going to go back to where you began in the beginning, which is you had asked everyone to introduce themselves. And in doing that, we came one step closer. We got to know each other a little bit better. And I want to know you because I belong to you. So tell me a little bit about yourself.
Well, fantastic. Shalini, my name is Kevin. My forefathers are from India. I grew up and I was born and brought up in South Africa, and now I live in the United States of America. So I'm trying to figure out what I am, but I realized that I was born in a place called the world. So that's perhaps my country in oneness, the world.
And we've all come together like this. We're all immigrants. We come from different parts of the globe and different countries, and that is Sri Sri Ravi Shankar's vision, that when we come together, we remove our differences and we become part of this one world family. And when we become part of this one world family, the boundaries blur, the differences blur, and in harmonizing through culture, through arts, through music, we become part of this one identity. And this is what we are looking forward to celebrating. And Kevin, you had asked me where I come from. Exactly. So I come from, yes, a small part of Rajasthan. So I'm going to start from the small to the biggest, from the microcosm to a very small town called Udaipur, which is a world-class tourist destination as well, which is a town in Rajasthan, part of North India. And from there, coming from India, I came here to the United States. And I'm a writer, I'm also a journalist. But the one thing I want to share about my background is that, you know, I've covered breaking news, and all the news, it's a lot of loud news. There are, there's so much violence in the world, there's terrorism, and there's all kinds of, we are surrounded by a world of loud noise about violence. And I have always been told to cover things that are of a violent nature. Everybody runs if there's a bomb blast in Paris. But when there was this rock concert in Paris, or if there is a beautiful gathering like this, like that we have today, do people run to cover it? Do we make a big noise about it?
No, we don't.
We don't usually make a big noise about it.
So you're listening. So
we are all here to make a big noise about peace. That's why we are here. And I hope we'll join together in conveying this sense of peace to the world. Your being here is so symbolic. It is part of a beautiful coming together. And dance, culture, music festival makes us a lot more of who we are. And we start to belong to each other. So I belong to you.
And I belong to you.
And we hope you will do the same today. So just a short, this was a short introduction to a very important vision that the founder of Art of Living, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, has in place for celebrating the 35 years of the founding of the Art of Living. And how are we going to introduce that to everyone, Kevin?
Well, there's something about peace and meditation. And Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, he talks about when one person meditates, it's called tapas. But when you have 3.5 million people at one gathering in March in New Delhi from all parts of the world meditating, it actually has the ability to shift global consciousness. So it's all about being centered. It's all about listening. A few minutes ago, you mentioned something very important in talking about Lord Ganesha. He has big ears. And the reason he has big ears is because big ears symbolize you should listen. So when you listen, you have the ability to understand people more effectively. And when you listen, you learn more about people. You become more tolerant. You don't stereotype. You don't just react impulsively. Listening is key. So coming together for this particular event, we talk about peace, we talk about meditation, and meditation and peace together has the ability to help eradicate the world with all of these issues. So we have to make a big, big noise about this.
Yes.
As opposed to focusing on the negatives, I think we're going to talk about peace and we're going to focus on this event.
Right. And for right now, I think it's time for the most important part of tonight's, all of us gathering here, to share in Sri Sri's vision for the World Cultural Festival.
There we go.
Purpose of World Culture Festival is to give the world a message that the whole world is one family, number one. Second, it's to give a message we can all coexist with our differences. Third is, it's an opportunity for religious leader, businessmen, politician, everyone to come together and renew their vision to work for the welfare of society. And then fourth is to care for environment, to create a buzz in the world about we care for the rivers, we care for the mountains, we care for the trees and plants and the environment. This is some message that we need to pass on to people. Another idea, the sixth, would be to encourage the traditional musicians, people from every country who have been preserving the folk dances, folk music, traditional dances and music, to give them a platform, world platform, for everyone to relish, enjoy that. This is something that would really bring the values which are going to the background, to the forefront. Like this, we can think of many ideas, and also give to the world a message, yeah, good people in the planet are there, they are dynamic, they are active, they care for the planet, they care for life. You know, this message that we care for the planet, we care for every individual too, this message we need to bring to the world loud and clear.
La vida es muy corta para decir que no. ¿Qué puedo hacer para ayudarte?
Aquí me Giovanni, vine aquí, mandate.
Ah, mi amor, tem que vir, né? Não dá pra perder um negócio desse. Vai ser incrível.
A mim, Dilli, vai ter tudo que vai fazer. WCF settings, zaruria.
A vida é muito curta pra dizer não.
Tchau, Papa!
Oh, my God. Lass deine Träume wahr werden. Make your dream come true.
Wow, what
World Culture Festival.
Sagay Mulun Zawiya! Sagay Mulun Zawiya! Sagay Mulun Zawiya! Sagay Mulun Zawiya! Sagay Mulun Zawiya!
Just do it! Dann denk so mal! Hey!
Wo ein Wille ist, ist auch ein Weg.
Just do it!
What are you waiting for?
Zindagi na bolne ke liye bahut choti hai.
人生太苦短，绝不说不。
Estão perdendo tempo com o quê?
Vem, gente!
Hace que tu sueño se vuelva realidad.
Yes, so how many of you are going now to the next part of our program, which is, we have a speech from the Indian consulate. We are very honored to have him here with us. And we have Mr. O.P. Meena, representing the Indian Consul General. And thank you for supporting us in this very important venture. Mr. O.P. Meena.
Thank you, Sadhanaji. Good evening, friends. First of all, I would like to thank Mr. Vreshwiram and the organizer of today's event for inviting me and giving me opportunity to speak on the platform of love, peace, and harmony. I know the Art of Living Foundation for a long time, but came closer last year during first International Yoga Day celebration. I would like to thank and express my gratitude to Art of Living Foundation for collaborating with Indian Consulate and making the first International Yoga Day so successful. I would like to thank Mr. Vresh Virani providing me opportunity to meet with a global humanitarian spiritual leader, harbinger of peace, love and harmony, and founder of Art of Living Foundation, His Holiness Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji, last year at Chicago Airport. I was blessed with love, peace, and happiness. Thank you very much, Vinayasi. Today, the world is facing a lot of humanitarian problems and crises created by human himself. Some countries are facing terrorism, where peace, joy, and love have become meaningless. I am feeling proud that Art of Living Foundation is spreading message of peace and love, happiness in these countries without any fear. I salute Art of Living Foundation for its dedication. On the occasion of establishment of 35 years, Art of Living Foundation is celebrating World Culture Festival in New Delhi from 11th March to 15th March 2016. I am thrilled to learn that the World Culture Festival brings people of diverse backgrounds across different nationalities together. This will set an agenda for unity. The World Culture Festival will be a live demonstration of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, which means that the world is one family. I congratulate the Art of Living Foundation on their 35th anniversary and wish the very best for the World Culture Festival. Most importantly, for the strength bringing to the global dialogue on peace and unity. Thank you very much.
Mandi Nadam by Jati Dance Academy, which is located in Naperville, choreographed by Jyoti Vangara. She conducts Kuchipudi classes in Naperville, performed by Akshaya Potluri, Sai Richita Pula, Naga Trisha, Ajanta Saraswati.
Thank you.
Shreya Ghosan, Isha Patel.
Yeah. Thank you.
applause to the choreographer, Gauri. And thank you, Mirasha.
Culture is one of those things that defines our lives. It makes it more vibrant, it makes it more meaningful. It makes us a little bit more of who we are. And after all, what is there in life but to celebrate? And celebrating the cultures of only one country here. Even that, in this short time, we've had so many different, what we call rasas, or moods, and colors, and different evocative themes. And even one evening would not be enough. But culture is also a reflection of our faith, of the universality of all our faiths. And to honor that tonight, we will have scholars from different faiths talking about what is important in their faith and how that lends itself to the universal idea of the one world family. So to begin with, we have a Hindu scholar, and then that will be followed by a Muslim, a Jew, a Baha'i, and a Nepalese scholar. So Kevin will tell us a little bit more about them.
Thank you. So it's all about diversity, very, very crucial. So I'm going to start by introducing Brett Cohen from an organization called Stand With Us, an educational organization that works with peace in the Middle East and to educate about Israel around the world. So I'd like to call Brett Cohen, Executive Director.
Namaste, shalom, peace be with you all. Thank you for inviting me to be with you this special evening. I bring you greetings from Jerusalem with the hopes of the Jewish people have lived for 3,000 years and where I will be next week in my work with students from around the world to make our shared ancient vision a reality. The Jewish people and the Indian people have a lot in common. We are both ancient peoples with calendars that have been counting for over 5,000 years. Today, we both live in our homelands, speak our ancient languages, and have cultures that are unique, and at the same time, the foundation for so much of the culture of the world. Both India and Israel achieved independence from British hegemony in 1948, and had our countries divided in the hope for peace with a hostile neighbor. And we've tried to work for peace ever since. The reality today is that the danger of violent extremism has spread, and that all of our struggles are interconnected. The organization I represent, Stand With Us, has a motto that education is the road to peace. Peace must be taught. Peace takes work, and peace starts with children. Today in Israel, the situation is serious. What makes a teenage Palestinian child stab a Jewish grandmother walking home with her groceries? That happened earlier today. This child was born a decade after the peace process began, yet the lessons that he learns in school radicalize him to hate. This type of hatred is learned. At Stand With Us, we're a diverse group of people. We're Jews, Christians, Muslims, Hindus, Buddhists, atheists, who all agree that for peace to happen, it needs to be taught. That child should have been taught to carry the old man's groceries. Instead, he was taught to hate and murder. If we want coexistence, if we want to actualize the world that the Hindu and Jewish sages envisioned thousands of years ago, then we need to act. We need to teach peace. We need to stand together and demand that the poisoning of young minds with hatred cease. Peace will only come if we make it, and education is the road to peace. Thank you. Namaste. Shalom. Good evening.
Thank you. Thank you, Brett. That was really heartwarming. The next speaker, we have Mr. Manoj Akhtar, President of the Federation of Indian Association of Chicago, also the president of Lakeshore Muslim Community Center. And Mr. Manoj Akhtar would now represent the Islamic community. So welcome, Mr. Akbar. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you, Kevin. Good evening, brothers and sisters of the mankind. Thank you very much for joining here. It will be unfair if I do not thank Mr. Vinesh Virani, the program director, and his team for the tireless efforts to make this success, to bring the peace. Thank you so much. When the world talks about India, the only thing comes across our everybody's mind is the 1.2 billion population. Over 1 billion population living in a nation called India. In that population, over 1 billion people is a number of different and shared cultural values. In India, we have people of all religions and ethnic backgrounds. And within the Indian culture, we have the variance of regional cultures as well. In a way, India is a representation of the world today. Surely, as it continues to grow as a nation in all aspects, India will be on the world stage, representing values of all people. I personally want to thank our humanitarian ambassador, Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji, who tirelessly working in 152 countries to bring the peace. Out of 196 countries, we already achieved 152. What he left, let's help him out to bring the rest of the countries in a peace. As an Indian, I born and raised in Hyderabad and migrated to United States of America. I've been watching all my life. These are my heroes who's trying to bring the peace around the globe, not just only in India. Give a big round of applause to Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji. Thank you so much. I want to thank everyone who's joining here, especially from the consulate office, OP Meena Ji, and Jai Hind.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Akbar. That was moving and very powerful. Just wanted to mention a very important quote when Brett spoke about hatred. Something came to my mind about a very powerful quote on hatred. And this is a quote by Nelson Mandela, and it states so powerfully that no one in this world is actually born hating another person because of the color of his skin, or his background, or his religion. You see, what Brett mentioned was, people must learn to hate. And if they could learn to hate, they could learn to be taught love. For love comes more naturally to the human heart than its opposite. And that is a very, very powerful quote by Mr. Nelson Mandela. And I resonate with our speakers, and I say thank you for putting that message across. I have one more speaker, a very, very close friend of mine. Many of you in Chicago would know the very, very beautiful house of worship called the Baha'i Temple in Wilmette. And the Baha'i faith is an amazing faith that embraces unity, talks about love, and unity and diversity amongst multiple faiths, religion, culture. So I'm very blessed to have a colleague from representing the Baha'i house of worship. And I'd like to call over Bridget Schneider-Kelling to say a few words on behalf of the Baha'i faith. Thank you, Bridget.
And everyone, thank you very much for having me. And I just want to say it's such an honor to share this floor with the strength and the beauty that we have seen in these dancers tonight. It's just absolutely incredible. You all are wonderful. So thank you. So I am a Baha'i. I am not a Baha'i scholar, but I did search some quotations that I hope you will enjoy from the Baha'i faith. So I will read those now. Baha'u'llah, the founder of the Baha'i faith, says, "There is a sign from God in every phenomenon. The sign of the intellect is contemplation, and the sign of contemplation is silence. It is an axiomatic fact that while you meditate, you are speaking with your own spirit. In that state of mind, you put certain questions to your spirit, and the spirit answers. The light breaks forth, and reality is revealed. The spirit of man is itself informed and strengthened during meditation. Through it, the affairs which man knew nothing of are unfolded before his view. Through it, he receives divine inspiration. Through it, he receives heavenly food. Meditation is the key for opening the doors of mysteries. In that state, man abstracts himself. In that state, man withdraws from all outside objects. In the subjective mood, he is immersed in the ocean of spiritual life and can unfold the secret things. This faculty brings forth the invisible plane of sciences and arts. Through the meditative faculty, inventions are made possible. Colossal undertakings are carried out. Through it, governments can run smoothly. This faculty of man enters him into the kingdom of God." And so then I have a quotation about unity. "Although we are of different individualities, different in ideas of various fragrances, let us strive like flowers of the same divine garden to live together in harmony. Even though each soul has its individual perfume and color, all are reflecting the same light, all contributing fragrance to the same breeze which blows through the garden, all continuing to grow in complete harmony and accord. Become as waves of one sea, trees of one forest, growing in the utmost love, agreement and unity." And then I have a few quotations about charity. "Blessed and happy is he that ariseth to promote the best interests of the peoples and kindreds of the earth. It is not for him to pride himself who loveth his own country, but rather for him who loveth the whole world. The earth is but one country, and mankind its citizens. One righteous act is endowed with a potency that can so elevate the dust as to cause it to pass beyond the heaven of heavens. It can tear every bond asunder and hath the power to restore the force that hath spent itself and vanished. Be ye a refuge to the helpless, a treasury for the poor, and a cure for the ailing. Be the helpers of every victim of oppression, the patrons of the disadvantaged. Think ye at all times of rendering some service to every member of the human race." Thank you very much.
Wow, the energy is just amazing when everybody listens to diversity. It's just unbelievable to look at how attentive everybody is when people from different walks of life come through. We have two more speakers. I know some of you might be hungry. The appetizers have faded out, I think so. I'm just gonna, yes, second, sorry about this. I have so many pages actually because I didn't carry my iPad. So I'm gonna call And when we talk about diversity, this is very interesting. I'm actually going to call Pam Brockman to represent the Catholic Society. And Pam Brockman, interesting enough, is a Arts of Living teacher. And I'm very pleased and honored to have Pam to come up and say a few words.
I just wanted to say a few words about Christianity, and just like the Islam faith and the Baha'i faith and like the Jewish faith and all the major religions and the minor religions all over the world, Christians celebrate human values. And just like Brad had said, it's just the fundamentalists who are few who have brought misunderstanding and discord, but at its root, every single religion strives for and celebrates all human values. And the main proponent or the creator of Christianity, Jesus Christ, was called the Prince of Peace. And peace, hope, faith, and love are the main human values of Christianity. And in Art of Living, which is not a religion, but is a celebration of humanity and techniques, how to bring that, all those human values back to liveliness and our being, also celebrates peace and brings peace to the individual and to the society. So thank you so much for coming this evening. And we celebrate peace. We hope to have you join us in India. And for those of you who can't, our big festival on March 11th through the 13th will be actually webcasted. So you can participate that way too. And each day there'll be a wonderful meditation. I think if there's time, we'll get to do a meditation here together. So thank you so much, Kevin, and thank you so much all for coming.
Jai Gurudev. When I say Jai Gurudev, you should respond me also.
Jai Gurudev.
Jai Gurudev.
I know you are hungry, but I'll not take a long time, okay? Let's say again. Jai Gurudev.
Jai Gurudev.
Jai Gurudev. We heard all the speakers, they're all dignitaries, and everybody appreciated Sri Sri Ravi Shankar's work, his organization, and his volunteers also. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude to all the organizers, who bring up this event, inviting all the dignitaries, particularly the representative from the consulate office, Mr. Mina. Okay. Now, since every day, I would like to ask you one question. Everybody is working something. Since morning until they go to bed, the parents, children, any work person who is own the hotel, or the people who works in the hotel, everybody is working. But what could be the ultimate goal of everybody after that work? I want that answer in one word only. Yes.
Happiness.
Okay. After happiness, if you are happy, then what you will have?
Peace.
There you go. Everybody's working, the ultimate goal is peace. If anybody comes to you, or any beggar comes to you, then you will give him what you have. Unless you have the peace, you will not give the peace to others. So first, you have to have peace. And that peace is not anywhere. It is within you. And that peace within you, you can find out if you follow the five commitments which I'm going to tell you right now. And believe me, I have such experience also. After following these five commitments, you have to make these commitments every day with your life before you leave your bed in the morning. The first one, just for today, I will not be angry. You have to make these commitments because whenever you breach this commitment, your mind will alert you. Oh, you made a commitment, why you are angry? So next day, you will breach the commitments less time. First day 100 times, next day maybe 80 times. Who wants to be angry? Nobody. Other factors are making you angry. So other factors are working as a remote control key. They press the button and you are angry. So you need to learn how you can be out of that remote control. Before you tell anybody, because of you I was angry, that is also wrong. Before you blame anybody, try to think with yourself, check yourself. And believe me, 90% you are the root cause who made you angry. For example, a little child is walking on the sidewalk, met his friend, father met his friend, started talking. After 5 minutes, son said, "Daddy, let's go." Son said, wait, I'm talking with my friend. After 5 more minutes, the son became a little angry and said, "Daddy." Son also said, "I told you." After 5 more minutes, the son became a little more angry. He said, "Daddy, let's go." Then father couldn't control himself. He slapped his son. After that, he thought, why he became angry? He checked himself and he thought, "Oh, my son, he alerted me first, but I didn't listen him." So the root cause was him. What I mean to say, before you do anything, say anything bad to anybody, or blame anybody, check yourself. Most of the time, you are the root cause for that thing. So don't be, "I will not be angry." With the anger, after angry, you will lose your energy. You will not be able to concentrate your mind towards the goal. Now, second commitment. Just for today, I'll be honest. Honest to your society, to your family, parents, at work, everywhere. Third one, just for today, I will not do anything which may invite worries to me. Considering the time that I don't have time to explain all these things. The fourth one, just for today I will do at least one work which will be helpful to the living entity. And last one, fifth one, just for today I will keep my face smiling. If you keep these commitments, make this commitment every day and maintain this for 21 days, believe me, people, you will be at peace and people will find peace in you and they will come to you seeking for the peace. Thank you very much.
So, thank you, Mr. Joshi, for your wisdom. Trying to figure out how you all smiling, having to be hungry, but we're almost there. When we talk about peace, just a very quick quotation by Mother Teresa, because peace seems to come out so often. Mother Teresa states that if we have no peace, it's because we've forgotten that we actually belong to each other. So that's a very powerful quote. So with further ado,
stop. Thank you. Thank you.
Sort of pumped up, and it's fantastic. And I must admit, Sandeep, I still have goosebumps from your performance, and they were absolutely amazing. So I noticed some folks have started to have dinner, which is fantastic. You could still partake in the next 10 to 12 minutes. It's a very, very special 10 to 12 minutes, and you're most welcome to partake in this event. So what I want to do right now is introduce you to a very, very special person in my life and to many others out there. And I want to introduce you to Neetha Virani. And a bit of background about Neetha. Neetha has been working and been part of Art of Living since 1997. And Neetha has actually been teaching since 2004. She teaches the Happiness Course, she teaches Sahaj. Neetha also works for a Fortune 500 company. And again, Neetha has touched the hearts of so many students, including me, so thank you. Neetha's commitment to Art of Living is grounded by her passion, attributed to the principles and values of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. And I know that Neetha is definitely a light that shines in this world, so thank you. Neetha is going to help you through a guided meditation, and joining Neetha is going to be a very, very good colleague of mine. We are very, very blessed to have him in this country, to have him in Chicago. Birju Vaishnavaj. He's currently studying his doctorate in being a physicist, doing research on cancer, and he also studied black holes. Very, very intelligent, Birju. Fortunate enough to have so much of exposure to Sri Sri Ravi Shankar and to be blessed directly by his knowledge. So I'd like to invite Neetha and I'd like to invite Birju. Thank you.
Thank you, David.
Okay, so it has been a long evening, and many of you sat through very patiently. I know some of you are very hungry, so this is optional. Okay, so if you'd like to go and start your dinner, you're welcome to do that. If you'd like to stay back and do a few 5-10 minutes meditation, then you can stay back and do that. Yeah. So if you'd like to do that, then maybe we can turn off our cell phones. Yeah, should we do that?
Or you can put it in the silence.
So you can sit comfortably. We can start with this technique called alternate nostril pranayama. Some of you already know this, right? Alternate nostril pranayama. So you can hold the palms. If you do not know, just in case, then we hold just a little bit stylistic posture. Keeping the ring finger on the left nostril and the thumb on the right nostril, and the first two fingers just touching the middle of the forehead, middle of the eyebrows, just lightly brushing. And then you can breathe out from the left nostril and then breathe in and breathe out from the right. Breathing like that. So let's close our eyes. Let's breathe out from the left nostrils. And breathe in from the left. And breathe out from the right. Breathe in from the right. Breathe out from the left. And continue alternating the other hand open on the lap. Breathing in from one side, breathing out from the other, breathing in from that side, and back. And you can relax the hand, keeping the eyes closed.
Your hand too long. Let's keep our eyes closed.
Relax the hands, palms in the lap. And keeping the palms in the lap. Sit comfortably, palms open, palms facing up.
Just keep your eyes closed. Let's take a deep breath in. And let go. And take another deep breath in. And let go. Once again, take a deep breath in. And when you breathe out, just breathe out with your mouth. Deep breath in. And breathe out with your mouth again. The next breath in, become aware of your body. Become aware of your feet. Aware of your knees. Your thighs, hips, your stomach, your chest. Your shoulders, your neck, your face, your whole body. Take another deep breath in and let go. become aware of the noises around you. The noise of the people talking. Noise of schools and plays. The noise of the door. Noise of your own breath. Become aware of all the noises around you. Accept all the noises. Now you are in the harmony with the environment. Again, deep breath in. And let go. Do not resist. Let them come. Now you are in the harmony with your thoughts. Once again, deep breath in. And let go. Become aware of your feelings. You are joy and peace. Become aware of your feelings. Become aware of your thoughts. Become aware of your sensations in your body. Become aware of your environment. Once again, take a deep breath in. And take a slowly and gradually, when you feel ready, you will open your eyes. Is it good? Even for the lot of noise, did you get a little bit of peace in your mind?
Oh, yes.
That's good.
Did you notice the time? It's close to 15 minutes. So, yeah, we have Vinesh Bhai who put this whole show together.
No, no.
We need to have a big round of applause for him.
it's almost 9:30, and I'm gonna do the closing speech. After that, we're gonna have more singing by the two fabulous singers. And I know a few of my friends already start their dinner in the back, but that's okay. So good evening, friends. And I'm very privileged with very short notice, all of you are here and support the Art of Living Foundation World Cultural Festival, which is going to be held next month in New Delhi. And the vision of Gurudev, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, is to bring peace, harmony, and bring all the culture, diversity, and people together in one platform. Tirelessly, he's working for last 35 years, and we are celebrating last 35 years under his guidance, under his vision. And we joined in different years. When we started Art of Living initially, and thanks to my wife Nita, who tell me to get into it, I was not into any kind of meditation or yoga or doing any kind of community work. And I started back in 98, right after her. And now, when we see, there was only one teacher. We have it in Chicago. We have a teacher named Pam Brockman. Is she here? Pam, oh good. So, Pam, can you please come here? I want to bring all my teachers of Art of Living to the stage here, so people should aware with their busy lifestyle, with their commitment to their family, commitment to their society, to their work, and they're doing a volunteer work, teaching meditation and spreading the Guruji's vision. So here's Prem Brockman. We have Emily Lifton also. Emily. Where is she? She's gone? Okay. Okay, she. We have Deepika Desai. We have Deepika Desai. Is she here, Deepika? Can you please let her know that we need her? Same here, we have a Birju Vaishnav. He's all the way from India. And Kevin didn't say, but Kevin probably don't know. He already have a 2 PhD degree and he's pursuing his third. So Birju is assets to us, you know. My wife Vita, as you met her before. We have Chandni Trivedi. She is teaching to the young children called Art of Excel. Come Chandni, Nita. We have Rajaram Bhai Soni, who just moved three years back from India. We have Karthik, who is a new teacher. It's not that new, but very young teacher. Very young. We have Bhavesh Patel, he's also a teacher from India. Shama, please come. People know her as a Shama Desai. She is the one who really, really working hard. She is driving the fundraising effort of the Art of Living and working very tirelessly. And I always say, I'm giving kudos to your husband, not to you, you know. Medha Garud, she is our a teacher, not even teacher, but she also spread the Ayurveda. She is the ambassador for our Ayurveda, and she is an excellent, excellent physiotherapist. You know, people, I'm sure, aware of those teachers. Am I missing anyone? Sonia Arora, she is coming all the way from Rockford. And surprisingly, we have a teacher coming all the way from Argentina. She is going to India tomorrow and she has a stopover, and we request her to please come and join us. Her name is Bian, I believe, Belen, because I'm probably not spelling her her name, but Belen, if you are here, please come. people should, I'm not sure if you guys, how much you're aware of it, but Argentina, almost, how many percentage of people would be out of living in Argentina?
There's at least like a 60% of people in Argentina.
60%. Just imagine teaching the meditation and yoga, 60% out of the country, and how many teachers we have?
Between water, breath and sound and art of living, it's around 700 teachers.
700 teachers. Yeah. So just imagine that, what is the Guruji's vision, how he's spreading the love of peace and a meditation throughout the continental of not just the one or two, but there is a, we have a Kevin all the way from South Africa. So we meet so many different people here in this country under the one umbrella called Art of Living, where we don't teach any other stuff besides the how to work together and work in the one society under the one umbrella. This is the opportunity. I want to thank all the community leaders. I have a couple of presidents here, FIA president, Mr. Ninaz Akhtar, and our VHPA, Vishwa Hindu Parishad of America president, Dr. Seth, Dr. Chamal Seth is also here. Can you please, both of you, come here? I would love to have you guys here. Even Rohit Bhai Joshi, because from stand with us, my good friend Peggy, unfortunately she's not here, but Brett is here representing the stand with us. And I'm not going to bore you more. I want to also thank my dear friend Nakul Chan from Air India. And we have a privilege to see what Air India can do. Last week in a movie theater, there is a movie called Airlift, where it's a world record, but unfortunately they are not accepting this, but 175,000 people that Air India bought them from Middle East when there was a war started, without any casualty, working with the government of India and government of all the different countries in Middle East and bring those people back. A tireless job by Air India pilots. And I must thank Nakul Bhai to show us that movie last week, and want to bring him here also, if he can say a couple of words. Nakul Bhai. And I'm not hoping, but I'm sure we will have a first American Indian Hindu representing us in our Congress, and love to hear his voice, love to want him to speak a little bit and let people know what he and how can he make a difference, you know. Indian community, we are in a third generation now, almost third generation, and Raja is a second generation person, and Raja works tirelessly with a lot of different community work, a lot of different community people, and all the community came together to support Raja, which is excellent. And Raja not just belongs to us, Raja belongs to each and every American's heart. So please welcome Raja. Raja, can you say a couple of words?
Jai Gurudev. I am honored to be here. Thank you so much for having me. Vinesh has been a dear friend. Can you give the Varani family a big round of applause? Thank you so much for Art of Living and the whole community. Some people talk about the Art of Living. They live the Art of Living. And I think they do it every day. And so I'm just so honored to be here. I should tell you that I am running for the U.S. Congress. The election is coming up in 38 days, March 15th. And are you excited as I am about the election?
Yes, we are.
Now, I didn't come here to give a political speech. I came here to talk about you. I came here to talk about you because you are my inspiration. I see Nimish Jani, who's a proud public servant for the community.
Nimish Bhai.
I see Please stand up, Nimish Bhai. Yeah, I see Minhaj Akhtar, who's a proud public servant for the community. Please come up. I see all these people who are doing public service, and I'm just taking the next step. I stand on your shoulders to run for the US Congress. Many of you came here to this country, like my family, with nothing in your pockets. Nothing. But you came here with your culture, your traditions, your value, and you came here with your work ethic. And you worked tirelessly, day and night for your families. You put food on the table. You put a roof over their heads. You educated your beautiful children. And now you have become a success in the greatest country the world has ever known, the United States of America. And I stand on your shoulders to reach for the stars, to be in the world's greatest deliberative body, the United States Congress. So, although my name is Raja Krishnamurthy, it might as well be Raja Jani, a Raja Varani, a Raja Akhtar, a Raja Khan, Raja Patel, Raja Shah. The point is this, when I go and have a seat at the table, you will have the seat at the table. When I have a voice in the highest halls of power, you will have that voice. In short, when I go to Congress, you will be going to Congress. And that is why this election matters. That is why this election matters. Now, we are in a spiritual place, the Art of Living Foundation. And tonight we are at the World Culture Festival. Unfortunately, in 2016, there are voices out there who would preach bigotry, who preach hatred, who appeal to the worst impulses in our humanity. That is one path. Let us choose a different path. One of inclusion, one of tolerance, one of diversity, one of spirituality, one of dharma, good conduct, righteousness, one that embraces all of humanity. In short, one that celebrates all cultures, that celebrates all people, all religions, and all of you. I'll just say one thing. I am Indian American. I am proud of my values, I'm proud of my traditions, I'm proud of my culture, and I'm proud of you. And I will never ever run away from you. I will never ever shy away from you. I will never ever say that I am not Indian American. My name is not Bobby Swindle. My name is Raja Krishnamurthy. And so, I'll just close with one saying, which is yesterday's history, tomorrow's a mystery, but today's a gift. That's why we call it the present. I am honored and blessed to be with you here in the present to celebrate the future of our community, the future of our country, and how together we are going to Congress. And in Congress, hopefully we can teach the art of living and the art of governance, because they are intertwined. So I thank you so much. God bless you. I close with one thing, which is that we have yard signs. For those of you who would like a yard sign, we are planting them. We need to vote on March 15th. Thank you so much.
One correction. We're not going to wait till March 15th. We have 33 days left.
One correction. So we're not going to wait until 38 days, which is March 15th, but we will start 32 days later, which is early voting. So we will start voting first day of early voting, and we will form those libraries or those village halls and get Raja on the board. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Raja. Thank you, Nimish Bhai. Thank you, Akhtarji. So I want to thank the all community people. Few cannot come, Iftikhar Sharif Ji, who supported our cause, our program all these years. We have Balwinder Singh, who's not here, who always helped me with anything I do, any Art of Living activities happen. He always come front and help us out. Sohan Bhai Joshi. I'm just getting a few names. Rohit Bhai, Dr. Seth, and above all, our own consulate, Meenaji. Thankful to Consulate General that we have, who's really trying hard, and I think he's very much successful. I think we are almost there to bring all the FI together, and we're gonna celebrate first time in the city of Chicago, Independence Day under the one umbrella. And this is not going to happen if we didn't have the CG and his staff who works tirelessly. And I heard, and I always say to Meenaji that when I go out of town, because I travel with Sri Sri, people come to me and says, Chicago consulate is the best consulate. We ever have any problem, all the consulate, Vishwapalji, Mr. Bhati who just joined, Meenaji, and our own consulate general, they're all very helpful and work for us, community. So thank you, Meenaji, to come here and help us out. Also, I want to thank Saidji. He is a good friend of ours, always in the community. His wife, tirelessly, I see her. She's coming everywhere and helping and hand to hand. So thank you, everybody. And I want to, last thing I want to do is, I want to call good friend of mine, community person, always there for us whenever we need. She is an associate clerk, Beena Ben Patel. Beena Ben also not just represent Indian American community, but she represent everybody in Cook County. And she's always useful. Whenever we need something, all the community people goes to her, I know for a fact. And she is always smile, pick up the phone and say, yes, how can I help you? So Meenaji, please come.
Hi everybody. Congratulations, Virendra, Vinesh Bhai. It was a very successful program. Three things we learned today. I've been sitting here for 3-4 hours. And what we learned today from the art of living. Number one, purpose. Life without purpose is no good. Number one. Number two, who we are. Through Art of Living and Happiness course, we find out who we are. And third, very important, that believing in God, believing in Guru is very important. We grow personally and professionally beyond limiting beliefs. And I'm gonna read proclamation from the mayor, Rahm Emanuel. Office of the Mayor, City of Chicago, proclamation. Whereas between March 11 through 13, over 3 million people from a variety of cultures, faiths, and nations will join together in New Delhi for the World Culture Festival to celebrate the 35th anniversary of the Art of Living Foundation's establishment. And whereas the World Culture Festival will showcase traditions of dance, art, and music from around the world in order to foster a greater understanding of people from different faiths, nationalities, and backgrounds. And whereas the Art of Living was founded by His Holiness Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, who has spent his life traveling the world sharing a message of non-violence and peace. And whereas the Art of Living assists those dealing with various forms of stress, including veterans suffering post-traumatic stress disorder, victims of natural disasters, and those who wish to lead stress-free lives. And whereas global leaders will join together in New Delhi to discuss how to effectively establish a peaceful and prosperous world. And whereas Sri Sri Ravi Shankar continued to engage the city of Chicago in spreading a message of peace through meetings with civic and political leaders, as well as hosting numerous events that bring together thousands of individuals from around the world. And
Whereas on February 6th, the World Culture Festival Curtain Raiser event will take in Chicago place to assist in raising funds for the World Culture Festival. Now, therefore, I, Rama Emanuel, Mayor of the City of Chicago, do hereby proclaim February 6, 2016 to be World Culture Festival Curtain Raiser Event Day in Chicago and encourage all Chicagoans to celebrate the many contributions made by the Art of Living to our city and nation. Dated this third day of February 2016, Rama Emanuel, Mayor. Congratulations, Art of Living.
हो मारे या कोई मारे ना यहाँ अपनी भी थोड़ी अदा थोड़ा अंदाज है ऐसे है
Thank you.
You are required.
Thank you.
Isabel, but the Isabel, Marina, Marina, but the Isabel, but the Isabel, but the Isabel, Marina, Marina, hey, Johan, the head, Saval, the head, Kamal, the head, Jana, 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 but the Isabel, but the Isabel, but the Isabel, Marina.